since I've got just a short time to do this, I think I'd just like to lighten the mood a bit with a story that sort of sums up everything I'm going to say. It was said that a cemetery warden was going around the cemetery as they do to make sure that, you know, everything is cool and wonderful, so those who are dead can sleep in peace. And this particular cemetery had a thick wall that surrounded it. So usually this warden will go within the cemetery and will go outside of the cemetery. And obviously if you're outside of the cemetery, you don't see what goes on inside. So not to his knowledge, two boys came into the cemetery and were plucking some apples to go and eat, obviously. And what happened was that they had finished plucking the apples and they had lots of them on the floor. And this particular apple tree was very close to one of the walls. So they sat down and they started sharing the apples. So this is the way they shared the apples. One for you, one for me. One for you, one for me. Just at that point, the cemetery warden got to the other end of the wall and he heard, one for you, one for me. And in fact, he's been there already, he didn't see the body, so he thought to himself, God and Satan are sharing the people in the cemetery. So he runs very fast to the local vicar and tells the local vicar, you know what you've been preaching all this time about God and Satan and the dead? It's so true. Because God and Satan are sharing the people in my cemetery. He said, no, don't be silly, this is not true. He said, yes. But you see, what happened was that whilst they were plucking the apples off the tree, two apples fell over the wall. All right, so they were just going on with the accounting. That was not known to the priest and obviously the warden. So the priest, out of curiosity, said, you know, let us go. Because I can't believe that God and Satan are sharing the people in the cemetery. So then they all moved. They go to the wall and say, you listen for yourself. And yet, one for you, one for me. One for you, one for me. Just at that point, they have finished sharing the apple. So one of the guys then said, what about the two at the other side of the wall? Obviously, the vicar and the warden took to their heel. And they ran for their dear life because they were not ready to die. And the story of Easter is just simply that. Because Christianity was born out of Judaism. And in Judaism, they celebrated Passover. And Jesus Christ, who is our Lord and Savior, celebrated Passover. And the essence of human life is that you start one point at birth. And another point, you die. But the fact is that we believe that there is life after death.
Of course.
And whatever you do on earth, you will account for it after death.
On the day of judgment.
And so we strongly believe that in life, like I wasn't going to introduce that, like the imam said, it's very important that you treat people with care.
Absolutely.
With love.
Yes.
And the golden rule always applies. That what you don't want anybody to do against you, don't do to another person. And Jesus Christ sums it up in one thing, that love your enemy and then love your neighbor as yourself. So basically, Easter is the celebration of the Passover, which after that, he gave his blood. Because in the Judaism, tradition, every year there is an atonement made for the people, where the high priest will go into the Holy of Holies and do this beautiful act of sacrifice after the Passover lamb has been killed. And obviously, we believe that it is through the shedding of blood that we get remission of sin. And for that reason, in the course of the year, the blood clots. And when it clots, it doesn't speak forth mercy like it used to anymore. So every year, there must be renewal of that blood. Mm. And in our theology, we believe that Jesus Christ was given as the Passover lamb, that when that sacrifice is made once and for all, there will be no need for every year renewing that. So the Bible that we believe in tells us that the blood is a blood that sprinkles on the mercy seat consistently. That takes care of our past sins, our present sins, and our future sins. And by that blood, we can treat one another with care and love, regardless of our race, political persuasion, religious background, and ethnic affiliation. Because the blood of Jesus unites all nations and put people together. And that is what I believe.